So we're going to take our mechanical front pointer. It's a plate with a stick that has graduated numbers on it. Slides in right where the wedge goes in. Okay? There's a little line on here etched in place. This is magnetized. We're going to put our stick right there, and you may be able to see that we have 101, 100, 99, 98, etc. We're checking to see if we're on at 100. So you want to be straight on and make 100, the 100 line up with the etched line on the device. Next, we need to raise the table up until the plane of this device just touches the stick. Now that is very difficult to do without some practice. I usually get my face right down close to it, and as you get closer, you may or may not be able to see on camera, but there is a reflection of this device on the surface of this, and it's very difficult to see.
Went at it again. Yep.
You can see it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if you get your face right down even with the plane, you can see how the reflection comes up to meet the stick until they just touch. Okay? If you go up too far, it's going to jam the stick up into the device and move your 100 mark. We did not do that. Okay? So we're making contact. We're at 100 now. Pull it up. Take it out. Now, the face of the white box is now at isocenter. The face of this is 100 centimeters away. First thing we can do is turn off the light and look to see if the SSD light indeed indicates 100, and sure enough, it does. You can see the 100 dash is absolutely inside the etched mark. So we're sitting at 100. Okay. Field size is defined at isocenter. Okay, so now we can check the field size. What we want to do is change the field size until it aligns with the field size marks right here. You want to do, to the best of your ability, line up the field light until it aligns with the corner edges. Like that, okay? That should be 10 by 10. Now we can look at the digital readout. We're within tolerance. What we visually set as 10 by 10 at isocenter reads 10 by 10 on the digital readout. So that's great. Next thing we can do, now that we have our field size set, our distance is set, we know it's correct, we have everything aligned, we checked the level of the collimator so that we know the collimator rotation is correct. So we line this up to the projected collimator rotation so we know this is set in space correctly as well. Now we can check our lasers. Our lasers should fall within this little circle. Okay? They're not absolutely perfect, but they're pretty darn good. You can also see our sagittal laser is shining here as well. I can block the sagittal laser and then unblock it. It falls right in line with the sagittal portion of the CR as projected from the collimator. Okay? The last thing I normally check is the overhead laser. Just move the gantry out of the way and let the overhead laser shine on the white box. And sure enough, that's great as well. One can also check the back pointer laser. I don't think I have the white box set such that we'll be able to see it properly. On my particular unit, there's actually two back pointer lasers. One's coming into play right now. You can see it start to come in. I'm gonna go over 270. Can you see it? No.
Yeah.
This, as you can see, I'm hiding it, and now it's back. That's the back pointer laser. I will hide the other lasers. So that's the back pointer laser. It is also following within tolerance. Okay.